Given a cantilever beam 250 mm width and effective depth of 350 mm, is provided with two bars of 22 dia together with two bars of 18 dia, are curtailed in middle. The first case is when two bars are curtailed, then at a section, percentage tension reinforcement provided will be 100 into AST is 2 bars of 22 dia only, so 2 bars of pi by 4 into 22 square by B is 250 into D is 350, which is equal to 0.8688%. We know tau V will be equal to nominal shear capacity, that is VU by B into D, which is equal to VU is 110 into 10 power 3 in Newton by B is 250 into effective depth is 350 mm, so that will be equal to 1.26 Newton per mm square. To find tau C, after knowing percentage steel, we need to find beta value, that is 0.8 FCK by 6.89 percentage steel, which is equal to 0.8 into FCK is M25 concrete, so 25 by 6.89 into percentage steel is 0.8688, which is equal to 3.341. Then tau C will be equal to 0.85 into under root of 0.8 FCK into under root of 1 plus 5 beta minus 1 by 6 beta. We know beta value and FCK. Substituting, tau C will be equal to 0.85 into under root of 0.8 into FCK is 25 into 1 under root of 1 plus 5 into beta is 3.341 minus 1 by 6 into beta is 3.341. So tau C value will be obtained as 0.61 Newton per mm square. Our tau V, that is 1.26 Newton per mm square, is greater than tau C. So the design shear force should be designed for VUS, that is VU minus tau C into BD. Stirrup should be designed for VUS, that is equal to VU is 110 into 10 power 3 in Newton minus tau C is 0.61 into B is 250 into D is 350, that is equal to 566.25 kilonewton. VUS for vertical stirrups is given as 0.87 FY ASV into D by SV, which is equal to VUS, that is equal to 566.25 into 10 power 3 Newton. Assuming two-legged 8 mm dia bars as vertical stirrups, then 0.87 FY is 415 into ASV will be 2 into pi by 4 into 8 square into D is 350 by SV will be equal to 566.25 into 10 power 3. From this spacing, SV will be obtained as 224.35 mm. So provide a spacing of 220 mm center to center. Whereas in the case B, that is 2 bars of 22 dia and also 2 bars of 18 dia, both are without curtailing, they are continued till the free end, that is our case B. B is given as 250 mm and D is given as 350 mm. The shear force is same, so tau V will be 1.26 Newton per mm square only. Percentage tension steel at that section will be now 100 into AST will be 2 bars of pi by 4 into 22 square plus 2 bars of pi by 4 into 18 square by BD, that is 250 into 350, which will be equal to 1.45%. Then beta will be 0.8 into FCK, that is 25 by 6.89 into percentage steel, that is 1.45, that is equal to 2, which should not be less than 1. In our previous case also, beta should not be less than 1. Now, tau c will be 0.85 into under root of 0.8 into FCK is 25 into under root of 1 plus 5 into beta, that is 2, minus 1 by 6 into beta, that is 2, which is equal to 0.734 Newton per mm square. Tau V is greater than tau C. Tau V is greater than tau C. So, vertical stirrups are to be designed for VUS shear force, that is VU minus tau C into BD, which is equal to 110 into 10 power 3 minus tau C is 0.734 into B is 250 into D is 350 mm. So that will be equal to 45.775 kilonewton. For vertical stirrups, VUS is given as 0.87 FY, that is 415 into ASV is, let us assume, 2-legged 8 mm dia bars as stirrups, that is equal to 2 into pi by 4 into 8 square into D is 350 by spacing is SV, which is equal to 45.775 into 10 power 3 in newtons. Then spacing will be obtained as 277.53 mm. Spacing should not be greater than 300 mm and it should not be greater than 0.75 times of D, that is 350 mm. So it should not be greater than 262.5 mm. So it is exceeding. So provide a spacing of 260 mm center to center for 2-legged 8 mm dia vertical stirrups.